So this is where I'll get into the visuals. You can really go quite deep into this part of it, but I'll just try and keep it to the basics. The first thing we'll do is change the default style. If you look down here in the subtitle grid, you can see that the style for every line is set as default. And then if you look up here in the subtitle edit box, you can see that there's a drop down box that says default. If we press edit next to that where it says default, we can edit this default style. Here we have the font and the font size. If you edit anything here, it'll change the preview we have down here, but it's not going to update on the video. So if you want to see how it looks on the video, you have to hit apply. All right, let's get that down to a better size, and I'll change the font. Down here, we have the colors. So primary is the color of the font. Secondary has to do with karaoke effects, and you can probably safely ignore it for the most part. Outline is the color of the border. And then shadow is the color of the drop shadow. So I'll apply that so you can see it on the video. Over here, outline affects how thick the outline is. And then shadow is how far away the drop shadow is from the text. And then if you tick opaque box, it'll make the outline turn into a box kind of similar to what you see on YouTube subtitles. And then if you want your subtitles to appear like this, you probably don't want the shadow to appear. So to turn that off, you can set shadow to 0. And the outline width also affects the size of the box. So I'll turn that back down. I'll change the primary color of the text back to white. And to change the color of that box, you have to change the outline color. So I'll go into there, change it to black. And then with this slider over here, I can change the alpha of the color. So that's how transparent it is. So if I turn it down just a bit, we'll have a nice semi-transparent box behind our text. I'll apply that. Down here in margins is where you can change the default position of the text. It's also affected by alignment. So at the moment, it's aligned to the bottom. So if I change the vertical margin, it'll change it based on the bottom. So I'll go 30 and it'll be 30 pixels up from the bottom. But if I then change the alignment up here to the top, it'll be 30 pixels down from the top. I change it back to the bottom. Now I'm happy with this, so I can press OK and I can look through and see that everything has that same style now. However, for these captions at the end, I don't want it to look the same as the rest of it. So the first thing we can do is move it to where we want it to be. To do that, I'll go over to the visual typesetting tools over here. This button here, this first one, is where you can move the lines around. If I click and drag this top line, nothing's going to happen. This is because the placement is based off the origin point. And since these lines are currently in the exact same spot, Aegisub has automatically aligned them so that we can read both. So the origin point is actually down here at this little red box. So if I want to move it, I can hold that and then move it up here where I want it. And same for this other line. There's also tools for rotating the text normally. Rotating the text as if it's in a 3D space. Scaling. Clipping with a box. And clipping with a shape. all right, so I've got these lines where I want them for now. The next thing I'm going to do is change the appearance of the lines. So we don't want to edit this default style. We want a new style just for these. So to add a new style, you go to Subtitle, Styles Manager. In Current Script is the styles we already have in the video, and Storage is the default set of subtitle styles. If I have a look at this default style here in Storage, you can see that it looks like how the default style originally looks. So if you make a style that you want to set as the new default, so say this one I've just made now, what you can do is click on it and go copy to storage and click yes to overriding it. And now if I go over to the default in storage, it looks like that. Now every time I do a new set of subtitles in Aegisub, this will be the new default style. But back over here, we want a new style for these captions. So to do that, over in Current Script, I'm going to go New. Now you can't have multiple styles with the same name, so the first thing I'll do is change that style name. And then we can go into changing the basic styling. There are a number of ways you can approach this, but these subs that we have here happen to have a box behind them. So we can use opaque box for that. So I'll turn that on. But obviously it's not, if we apply it, it's not going to update here. So if we wanna see a preview on the video while working, I'll just go okay and close out of the Styles Manager. And I'm gonna set both of these lines to have this new caption style we made. So you can hold down Shift and click to select both of them. And then up here in the drop down, we should have that captions thing I just made. And that'll change it to this new style. Now we can go back to editing it to make it look like how I'd like. So first of all, I'm gonna change the font to make it match a bit more. I'm gonna change the font size. And I'm gonna also change the outline width to make it a bit bigger, so that the box ends up bigger. All right, I'm happy with that. However, we've got the issue of the colors. Obviously, all of these have different colors in them. So how are we going to do that? So I'll leave these colors as they are for now here. And now I'll fix the colors. So what I'll do is I'll go to Xion's line first. Over here in the subtitle edit box, we have these buttons we can use to edit the appearance of the text separately from the line's style. Any changes I make with these buttons will affect everything after the position of the cursor. So if I want to change everything, I've got to put the cursor at the start. And then I want to change the color of the box first. So if you remember, I mentioned before that opaque box is based off the outline. So I'll need to change the outline color. Here you can see that there's a button that has some text with a red outline. And if you mouse over it, it'll say set outline color at current cursor position. So if I press that, it'll come up with a color selector. If I click this eyedropper tool, I can sample colors directly from the video. So if I wanted the color of this box to match, I can click here with the eyedropper tool. And then in this little box here, I select what color I'd like. And then hit OK. Okay, you can see that we've got some stuff that's appeared here in these curly brackets. These are override tags. They represent things we've done to the text that's overriding the default style. In this case, the position of the text. And then this 3C here stands for border color. I'll put a link in the description that has a reference for all these different override tags if you're interested. All right, now I want to change the color for Triceratops. I'll put the cursor right before that bit. And the text here is red. So if we want to change that, we want to change the primary fill color, which is where this button with a red A is. So I click on that and then just do the same as before. Eyedropper, select, okay. And then if we want to change the box for the section to white, we go back to that outline color. And same as before. And that's it. I'll quickly do the same for Junkie's bit. Now that I'm happy with those, I'm gonna move them over on top of the original caption. And that's it. I've only gone over the very basics here. There's a lot of stuff you can do with override tags that you can't control with these buttons. For example, you can fade text in. I'll show you. And you can do stuff like blur the text. And you can do stuff like add in vector shapes, all sorts of things, but that's kind of beyond what I wanted to do with this video. But if you're interested, there's loads of resources out there for learning more advanced techniques. I hope, though, that this helped show you the basics you need to know for how to style text. In the next video, I'll show you one way you can quickly render out a clip for Twitter. Thanks for watching.